Hello everyone, my name is Shay and I'm a working special effects makeup artist. Today I'll be giving you some pro tips on how to simulate a cut or stab wound. Using a small tool, scoop out a small amount of modeling wax. With some lotion on your fingers, smooth out the wax and roll it into a small sausage shape. Pro tip, using lotion on your fingers keeps the wax from sticking to you. Here I'm using Aquaphor, but any non-glittery lotion will do. Apply spirit gum to the area you'll be applying the wax. Wait a few seconds, and then tap it to speed up the tacking process. Offer up the wax to the spirit gum. If your portion of wax is too large, simply peel some away and re-roll what is left into a sausage shape. Press the wax into the spirit gum. With the flat end of your tweezers, drag the wax into the skin to blend. Don't drag the wax too far out. Scrape away excess wax. With lotion on your finger, smooth out the wax and blend the edges. Pro tip, make sure the wax doesn't raise too far off your skin. Keep the wax as close to your skin as possible. Using a thin sculpting tool or toothpick, create your cut by gently dragging the tool through one end to the other. Pro tip, cut or stab wounds are generally thinner at the ends and wider in the middle. This is because the skin is under tension. Keep this in mind when creating your cut. Also, please use caution during this process. It's very easy to cut yourself. Take your time, this is a very important step. That's about right. Using a Q-tip, apply a thin layer of latex over the wax. This will keep the wax in place. Be sure to feather out the edges of the latex, or you'll get a harsh edge once it's dry. Don't forget the inside of the cut as well. Once the latex is dry, powder the area with translucent or HD powder. Watch out for loose brush hairs. With a small brush, paint the inside of the wound a deep burgundy color. This will create depth and make the wound appear much deeper than it actually is. Along the inside edges, use a deep red. With a textured sponge, stipple on some light red for irritation, as well as some light purple for bruising. Pro tip, extend the color beyond the edge of your appliance. This will not only help blend better, but it also adds realism. Add blood to the inside of your cut, then extend it out over the rest of the appliance. This is a stab wound, so be bold. But remember, blood is an accent, not the main attraction. Touch up any harsh edges or lines. And that's it, you're finished. If you like this video, please, please feel free to like my Facebook page and follow me on Instagram.